Hi there, I'm Jess, and this weekend I went to Rogue Events Asylum 12, which is a supernatural convention held in Birmingham every May, and also every October, but the ones in May are the big ones where guests like Misha Collins or this year Jared Padalecki can show up, and as you can tell from my wristband, I was totally there. Now, I also went to Asylum 10 last year, but since it was a whole completely new experience, I wasn't really paying that much attention to, like, filming videos and thinking about making vlogs, which is exactly what I was thinking of doing this time. So, I've taken a few little videos here and there, and I'm going to put it together and show you guys what it was like.
Carry on my wayward son, there'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest, don't you cry no more.
Now, I know what you must all be thinking. What the hell am I doing putting Get Lucky in a Supernatural Convention video? Well, it turns out that was the anthem of the weekend, and the other one was Let It Go from Frozen. Anyway, aside from the music, of course, the most important things at the weekend were the guests, and there were lots of them. They were Jared Padalecki, Amanda Tapping, Sebastian Roche, Misha Collins, Mark Shepard, Adam Harrington, Ty Olson, Osric Chow, Gabriel Tigerman, and AJ Buckley. We were supposed to get Jim Beaver as well, but due to work commitments he unfortunately couldn't make it. He was replaced at the last minute though by Tyler Johnston, the actor who plays Samandriel. Oh, and we can't forget Mark Pellegrino. Over his Twitter account he'd been musing over whether he was actually going to be coming to the con or not for months. Despite the lack of any official announcement though, he did make it. Although some of the regular congoers were missed, like Matt Cohen or Richard Speight Jr., particularly down to the lack of karaoke this time, every guest had their own panel, which was fantastic to watch. It would of course take forever to list every single one of my favourite moments from the panels because there were so many of them, but if I had to choose a favourite, it would probably be what was meant to be AJ's panel. It turned into an AJ with Travis via FaceTime, so we had both the ghost faces, and then halfway through Sebastian Roche panel as well. And let me tell you, you might have heard the rumours, but a panel with Sebastian Roche is like nothing you have ever seen before. He ended up dancing right in the seat next to me, and got the whole hall dancing and singing to Get Lucky and Beatles songs. It was fantastic. One of the panels that I, and I bet a lot of other people were looking forward to though, was the Misha and Jared panel, and we weren't disappointed. Apart from the fact that Jared did turn up about 20 minutes late, but Misha held the fort admirably, and not to mention, Rogue Events even let the panel go on 15 minutes longer than it was originally meant to, so kudos to them for that. They have, by the way, promised an episode of Cooking Fast and Fresh with West and Thomas, so be on the lookout for that in the future. Jared in particular sounded really enthusiastic about it, which was just really adorable. One of my highlights of the weekend was the Jason Manns gig. It was so nice to be able to sit down and just have a calm sing-along after such a hectic weekend, and Jason Manns' voice is truly gorgeous. Plus, Ty and Osric made guest appearances, which is always appreciated. I took some clips, so here, have a look.
I don't think we could really get a better view of the Jason Manns gig, to be honest. Look at this.
Of course, one of the main parts of the convention weekend is all the photo ops you're gonna take. I didn't really take that many because I'm trying to conserve money, but these are some of my favourites. Oh, and of course we can't forget the fact that you could take photos with Baby. Her owner was there and she was absolutely awesome and let us take photos inside of the car. That was definitely one of the highlights of the weekend, being able to feel like Dean Winchester for just a second. But the top highlight of the weekend was definitely being able to talk to Misha properly this year. Actually, no, that's a lie, because I think the highlight of the convention, the number one thing, was being able to meet so many people from across the world and make so many friends over the course of the weekend. Any convention's highlight should be making all these friends, I think, and this one was no exception. So, to end the video on a highly sentimental note, I'm going to play you out with some music and some of the photos with some of the great people that I met. Thanks for watching.
Don't you cry!